Light up at dawn just to be out on the water. The weatherman said hot and getting hotter, but he didn't say nothing about it raining like hell.
Dress up like fish. It's kind of goofy, but it kind of brings a town together. The heyday was when late 80s, early 90s was the biggest time that the shad were, you know, everybody knew about it. There were people from out of town coming in to fish with the shad. So, you know, it gets to be a
big old story to tell. All here. A bad day of fishing beats a good day of anything, yeah. Should probably go to work, I mean everybody does, instead of sitting out here in the middle of nowhere working on a pretty good buzz. Didn't get a damn thing, as you could say we took a licking. Tonight's fish fry's gonna taste like chicken, but we did just fine.
Now all we need is fish.
Dude, that's the best fucking line of this movie so far. I'm with the one-liner crew.
Play that guitar.
Just give me a brief overview, like the history, how long it's been going on.
Well, we're at the Forks of the Delaware Shad Fishing Tournament. The tournament started in 1983, and this is our 31st year. We had about 300 contestants sign up. It's a week-long tournament, and it's we have a lot of fun out here. Usually at the end of the, for the past 30 years, at the end of the tournament, we've always had a little picnic where everybody shows up, receives their rewards for the week, and again, we're all out here having a lot of fun.
That's fish fries gonna taste like chicken, but we did just fine, if I do say so myself. You know, a bad day of fishing beats a good day of anything else. You know, a bad day of fishing beats a good day of anything else.
Tree fall, so we took somebody's boat that they bought brand new and brought it and said, "Happy birthday, Uncle Jim." Got in the boat, he grabbed the pole, he started fishing, like, you know, in the parking lot, like an asshole. And next thing you know, all my little cousins who were like, you know, 2, 3, 4 at the time come out and they're all holding this big banner. It says, "April Fools, it's not your boat." He almost broke down in tears. Almost. But, you know, being the Shad King, he couldn't.
That's funny.
Yeah, this year, my uncle had a daily winner and his boatmate had a daily winner on 2 consecutive days, which wasn't bad. Which goes to show that we have a decent amount of fish where we fish. We use downriggers, shad spoons, jigs. There's all sorts of different lures you can use. There's the shad spoons are a small little thing. It's usually painted pink with an eye, and it's got a hook on it. You don't need to bait them. The shad are too stupid for that. They stomach, and they bleed to death. So that's why they keep all the shad, because once you catch them, you can't throw them back. It's just a good time. It's just it's a week off of work on the river fishing and drinking. But, you know, a lot of people aren't supposed to know that. But it's fishing. They go hand in hand. The one year my uncle fell off the boat. That shit was hilarious, too. He was fishing, caught a fish, went to go net it, and fell off the boat. That was a good year.
Shad have been running up the Delaware River forever. Indians ate them.
Now, why is it they run up the Delaware and no other rivers?
Well, they do run up other rivers. People don't realize that. Late January, early February, they start running into the James River in Florida, and then they work their way up the East Coast. They go into the Potomac, they go into the James River in Virginia, Delaware. I think they, if I'm not mistaken, they do run into the Chesapeake Bay area. Whether they run up to Susquehanna anymore, I don't recall.
Right. Video.
All right, we're recording.
No, that's a camera.
Hey, it's the WFMZ.
Okay. You want to spell my name right?
I will. How are you hitting them today?
I got two people. A guy named Jim Flynn, he just caught a couple.
What are the odds that this is going to keep going for years and years and years?
Well, I'm always optimistic, so I hope it continues year in and year out until I'm in the ground. I enjoy coming out here. I really had a lot of fun when I get time. It's a good day. Beautiful weather this year. No rain one day. But I enjoy coming out here and having a shot.
Does this bring a lot of families?
Yeah, we get a lot of family oriented. We have a women's challenge, so the guys and the gals get out there and fish together. Women have their own categories, so they have money prizes and everything.
I built up two shopping carts late last night. One was full of fishing gear, the other Miller Lite. Check out a lady laughing, said, "You think you've got enough?" And I said, "Yeah, you're probably right." And fill another two carts up. Don't catch all the fish, or drink all the beer, or anchor down, or stay in here. Might take all day, might take all year, to catch all the fish, to drink all the beer. So I picked up the boys at dawn, and we were on our way. Hadn't been 10 minutes before Jimmy's cell phone rang. His old lady asked him how long.
And that, my friends, is a shad.
Drink all the beer. Better warn her now. Better make it clear. Might take all day. Might take all year. Till we catch all the fish. Till we drink all the beer. Just as long as there's a can left in that cooler. Just as long as there's a bass left in that lake. That just means that we still got some work to do here. Just as long as there's still gas left in them tanks. Come
on. How do we get into it? If you want to sign up for the Shad Fishing Tournament, we have a brochure that you can pick up at a lot of the local stores. We also put it on the internet that you sign up for it. If you want a hat and pin, it's $35. If you didn't want the hat and pin, it's $25. But for the most part, like I said, we have a lot of people that signed up for it.
We caught all the fish, and we drank all the beer, and we ran out of gas. Now we're stuck out here, a bunch of empty cans, worthless fishing gear, 'cause we drank all the fish.
One more time.
One more.
Well,
all right.
I got the official. I have a life preserver because it's state law.
State law.
Some people don't obey the law. That's enough stuff.
Now we got, hey. Now your secret fishing hole's on TV.
Your wife's gonna be proud of you. Hey,